7 News starts right now.
Breaking news right now, and it centers on this man.
An escaped prisoner, armed, dangerous, and on the loose at this hour after he got away from the prison guards who were transporting him. He stole their guns, took them hostage, and then took off, triggering lockdowns at area schools.
Good afternoon. I'm Lucy Nolan.
And I'm Greg Hurst.
The guards say the inmate left them in the prison van. They're not hurt, but authorities believe the escapee's wearing one of their uniforms. The prisoner with a violent past made his break for it this morning in Baytown. And we've been at several scenes tracking the search ever since.
11 News reporter Shernmin Chow has been there all day providing constant updates to the 11 newsroom at khou.com. So Shernmin, bring us up to the minute now.
There's a lot of activity behind me on the backside of this old abandoned hospital. Authorities are concentrating on a couple places, including there, but they've asked us not to show you what is happening back there at this time. The escapee, as you say, is heavily armed. He left behind the weapon he brought on that prison van, but took with him two semi-automatic pistols and a 12-gauge shotgun, all from the prison van that he managed to hijack. As you can imagine, he is very violent. And in fact, in the past, we have interviewed one of his victims, a woman he nearly killed, his wife.
Bloodhounds, lawmen, from local police to Texas Rangers with rifles at the ready, combed the streets. Helicopters hovered overhead. On the loose, 49-year-old Arcade Joseph Comeaux. He was riding in a medical transport vehicle being moved from Huntsville to Beaumont. Around 6:30 a.m. while in Conroe, authorities say he pulled out a gun and fired a shot at the two guards, then commandeered their prison vehicle.
At some point, he got the correctional officers out of the vehicle, got their weapons, handcuffed them into the back of the vehicle, and then he began driving the van around in one of their uniforms.
He allegedly ended up in Baytown, where he abandoned the van. The guards kicked out the window to escape. Comeaux was in a wheelchair and reportedly paralyzed on his left side, but
he did not leave on a wheelchair. We believe he fled on foot, so obviously that raises some red flags for us to determine, you know, what exactly his medical condition was and the extent of that medical condition.
And I tried to run.
In fact, he was in a wheelchair in 1997 when he was at the Jester 3 unit in Fort Bend County. During a contact visit, he used his chair to pin down his wife, then grabbed a piece of it to stab her. The attack was so severe, a lifelike helicopter had to transport her.
He got up and was telling somebody that he got up out the chair and walked and began to chase me under the table when he was hitting him. He walked and did everything.
The two major questions, how disabled is Comeaux and
how would he get a pistol?
Yeah, that's a big concern. You know, offenders, when they are being transported, before getting into the vehicle, they're going to be stripped out and searched thoroughly. And so how that offender managed to get a pistol into that vehicle is something that we need to determine.
Authorities have been in contact with Leola Comeaux and other family members. About 2 hours ago, the lockdown was lifted at Lee College behind me and 4 other area schools. Comeaux had been in administrative segregation, isolated from other inmates because of his violence. He was serving a life sentence for aggravated sexual assault. His prior convictions include the rape of a child. At 6 o'clock, we will talk with a neighbor who lived inside the active search perimeter and tell you why she believed she needed to get out. We'll have that and the latest on the search at 6. For now, we are live in Baytown. Shernmin Chow, 11 News.